And just a couple moments ago, we got the 5 o'clock advisory, so we want to give folks at home the very latest information. This is expected to become a hurricane shortly after midnight and get a little bit stronger prior to landfall. Some of the models are indicating it could be a Cat 2. At either rate, even though it's that far off our coast, we are seeing the rain. We're getting those gusty winds. We're under a tornado watch now, in effect until 8 o'clock, and this will likely lift northward tonight as the storm system, which is almost due west of Tampa, continues to lift to the north. Now, outside, we've been tracking these squalls, these bands of rains up towards the square right there. They're doing very good. There's the front right quadrant right now. That puts the eastern and the eastern side of the wall there approaching Sumter Lake and Marion County. So that's what we have to watch here. The other thing we're watching is that surge. Look at the wave action now, closing in on 15 feet just off the coast there of Tampa Bay. We had a little water spout there earlier. A lot of wind reports. So far, so good here. In Central Florida, we've had a couple of warnings. We haven't had any tornado warnings. We're getting some of these gusty winds here. There's your first band coming right through the turnpike. The second one now lifting up just south of Sumter Lake and Marion County. And these are the bands that we're going to watch. And you take a look now at the velocity product. Every once in a while, you see a little broad rotation upstairs, not reaching the ground. So we've been pretty fortunate there thus far. Big band of rain coming through Osceola County, the metro areas. So far, so good in Titusville, but off towards the north and the west. Look at Claremont, Leesburg, the Villages, very heavy rain. And up here in Marion County, this is where we think the heaviest rains are going to be between now and tomorrow afternoon. With more on what to expect tonight, here's Kim Tran.
That's right, Tony. So we're already in the thick of things. We've already seen several storm reports out there from some of those severe thunderstorms that did fire up earlier this afternoon. In fact, we picked up wind gusts of 52 miles per hour near Azalea Park, winds of over 50 miles per hour out at Orlando International Airport already. So all these dots that you see there are wind reports. Down in the south here in Polk County are a couple of tornadoes that were reported. There were several tornado warnings that were issued for Polk County earlier this afternoon. With that severe weather risk, it is going to get higher as we go into the overnight hours and through tomorrow. Look at Central Florida. Most of us are under the level 2 out of 5 risk for severe weather overnight and into tomorrow. We are going to see a level 2 out of 5 risk, especially tomorrow afternoon into the northwestern portions of our viewing area. On top of severe weather risk, we're talking about tropical storm strength winds. We've already started seeing it so far this afternoon. It's going to get progressively stronger as we go into the overnight hours. Winds are about 45 to 55 miles per hour along I-75 points west. In the Orlando metro, about 30 to 45 mile per hour wind gusts, and a little less as strong, not as strong for areas along areas south and east of Orlando. So here's a look at the timeline. The worst of the weather will arrive overnight tonight, especially for areas west of I-75. Tomorrow, squally weather with gusty winds and strong storms. And then Tuesday, finally, Debby pulls away and will no longer feel the impacts directly from Debby. But from now into the overnight hours, it is a first warning weather evening because we do have the potential for strong to severe thunderstorms, gusty winds, as well as tornado, as well as a threat for the overnight hours. So make sure you have ways to get weather alerts. Chief Meteorologist Tony Manolfi will come up in 15 minutes showing you hour by hour when we'll see the worst of the weather, as well as county by county graphics coming up.